Stop it! We never could.
These niggas still retarded. Niggas stupid than a motherfucker.
I think that sometimes people confuse well-made with a good movie. Like a Paul Thomas Anderson movie puts me to sleep. But as I'm watching it, I'm like, man, this dude's, he's on some shit. Like he knows how to make a fucking movie. Holy shit. Like very few people can achieve that kind of stuff.
Well,
that
doesn't mean that
I'm into it.
Yeah. You know? I'll argue that PTA's older stuff is much better and a little bit more kind of grounded.
I try to watch Hard Eight.
I've never seen Hard Eight.
And I was like, yeah, I need to take a hard 8 hours of sleep. This is not for me, man.
That's a good one. I've not seen Hard Eight. I like Boogie Nights and like I think Magnolia is good, but you kind of just need to not be doing anything else for the rest of the day when you watch that because it's a real fucking downer, you know?
Yeah, like I love a feel bad movie. I do like Magnolia. He kind of just like punched everyone in the face at the end there, and I will never understand that ending.
I like it, man. I'm
just kind of like, all right, fuck you too.
Well, and wait, PTA did Punch Drunk Love too.
Yeah,
I love that film. I think it's great.
I liked it when I saw it. I don't think I'd ever watch it again.
Really?
Yeah.
But like There Will Be Blood, fucking There Will Be fucking snoring from my bed because I can't fucking get through it.
Thank you. No.
It's boring. Phantom Thread I saw in theaters at midnight. I regret that because
I remember us talking about that because when I first met you, I think Phantom Thread had just came out. Yeah. And I remember saying I tried it once in the theater and I bailed. I was like, oh, it's a matinee. Maybe it's too early. I need coffee. And I went back and I saw it again with a friend and he was like, no, you're going to love it. And it was like 7:30. And I'm like, why is 7:30 feel too late for this movie?
Yeah, I saw it. It was like an impulse thing whenever Movie Pass was around. And I'm like, fuck it. I don't have anything to do tomorrow. I said, my roommate, David, I was like, hey, man, you want to go see the Phantom Thread? And he was like, yeah. And I was like, all right, let's go. And so we went and saw it at the Grove. And it was like 11 or midnight or something like that. And I was just, couldn't do it. And you know, you and I are of the opinion. I remember I was like, I'm gonna like let you in on a little secret as an actor. Like, I'm not really that into Daniel Day-Lewis. And you were like, I'll do you one better. I'm not into Daniel Day-Lewis at all.
Yeah.
I don't think that's acting, you know?
It's not acting.
It's like the extreme of Dustin Hoffman in Marathon Man, but like where he'll like, I'm going to go be a cobbler in Italy for like a year before I assume this role, you know?
Well, it's nonsense. The whole like, no, call me Abraham Lincoln. And you're like, you know, you're standing out in front of a $20,000 camera, right?
Yeah.
Like to what end do we participate in the charade?
Yeah. I mean, I don't get it, man. I don't understand, like, you know, you should just be able to do it. Well, and he says he does it because he's not that good. And I'm like, well, you're right about that. You know, like
I was listening to that one old Brady Sinelis episode where Andrew McCarthy was talking about working with D'Onofrio.
Oh, and, I remember that one. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah. And he was just talking about the method and how McCarthy was just like, you know, I'm just an actor, but he was just kind of like, you know, I'm not impressed by seeing your work. Not when the camera's on, I'm going to be impressed when I see your work, when the camera's on. So, you know, a good director, this is me talking now, a good director will help an actor get through that do whatever they need to do to get there. But when the whole set has to be subscribed to your neurosis in order to get, you know, a 2 minute take, fuck off.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. Timothy Oliphant was on some, nighttime talk show. I don't know if you ever, if you ever saw this, but he was talking about how, you know, whenever Jim Carrey was doing Man on the Moon, mm-hmm. and he was saying that, you know, my character would do this or my character would do this. And Timothy Oliphant just sat there and basically just said to Jim Carrey, "Well, my character thinks your character is kind of a fucking asshole like that." And I was like, "Whoa, you know, shots fired, shots fired." And you know, he fucking he re it is kind of insufferable, you know, like I've seen I haven't really experienced it very much firsthand, you know, but it is. I had a buddy that was in a Disney movie when he was younger, and he was telling me like there was this guy, like he played like the bad guy that was in the movie or something like that. And he was like, the guy was totally method. Like he didn't talk to anybody or anything like that. And then you watch the performance, you're like, for fucking this? You know, like this is what we got? Like you fucking what, you assumed the mind of a serial killer or whatever, and like, you know, just immersed yourself and this is what we get, you know, like fuck that. It's self-indulgent, you know, like Jared Leto in Suicide Squad, fuck that. Why would anybody want to work with that guy after that, you know?
I mean, I guess it makes good fodder for the junkets. But at no point where I was like, oh, wait, he gave Will Smith a rat? Now I have to see this
I
movie.
know. Wow, that's so like captivating, you know? It's fucking stupid. He only really impressed me once as an actor too, which was in Dallas Buyers Club. 'Cause
Yeah, he was good in that.
I didn't even know that was him until the end of the movie. And I mean, I
Yeah, he
like him
was
in
good.
American Psycho too, 'cause he's a fucking prick, you know? And like
And
you really get to like
it's great to see him get whacked.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I always love the dance that Patrick does too, right before he fucking yeah, we're like fucking, I can't even do it.
Just hip to be square. A song so catchy, most people probably don't listen to the lyrics, but they should, because it's not just about the pleasures of conformity and the importance of trends. It's also a personal statement about the band itself. Hey, Paul! Ah!